Hey everyone, welcome to round two. I say round two because our opponent actually was not there and ran out of time, and so yeah, here we are. So our opponent's chosen to play first and is mulligan to six. We have library on the draw with Thoughtseize, so barring this being a very bad matchup, I can imagine that this is going to go poorly for him. So we will not mulligan this. Let's see if he is going down any further. Nope. He's at six, so we'll go ahead and open with LOA and see what happens. Ding 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 ding. Read the card. Oh, that thing. Seems fair, right? Library on the draw certainly is powerful. And let's see if we're playing against a white weenie deck. Nope, white blue. Let's draw a card. Nine cards, so we can go down to eight, Thoughtseize him. And this is going to get pretty ugly, if it's not already ugly. All right, so you can see we've got a pair of swords. I think I'm going to take one sword and then we can vindicate the next one. He's going to go. Probably going to take the sword of body and mind. It's not a bad one. So he has Sword of War and Peace, Plains, Island, Metamorph. Sword of War and Peace, Plains, Metamorph. Plains, Metamorph. Okie dokie. Let's go ahead and draw a card. And we can blow that up now so he doesn't play Metamorph to make another sword. I'll stick off of drawing a card to do that. So he's got a Metamorph that he can't really play, and we're just going to go ahead and probably play this Bitter Blossom. Ooh, we could play Mind Stone in the Bitter Blossom. So this is a bit of a beating. And the next turn we can play Sorin, and yeah, this is just going to go even further downhill for our opponent. Ooh, a Stoneforge Mystic. I wonder if he has an equipment to get still. We shall see. Sword of Light and Shadow. Jeez. That's a lot better. Well, we can Angel Despair that thing. Unfortunately, well, at least he doesn't have any creatures in his graveyard to get back. So let's go ahead and auto yield to that. Well, there's land that we need to cast Angel of Despair. So I think what I want to do is just. Let's see. Mind Stone can get our library back, so I'm just going to draw a card. I can play Grave Titan here. But I kind of want to just not play a good creature so you can't use the Metamorph. So. Go ahead and play this Sorin and make a guy. Now he can equip and then we can path it, and then he can play a Metamorph, but then we can play Angel of Despair. Basically, I want to play. Let's see. All right, so let's go ahead and path that thing. And now we can just start making emblems. Basically, I want to make sure that I don't play Angel of Despair before he plays Metamorph. Otherwise, things will get out of hand. So he's got a Metamorph and one other card. Mother of Runes. Okay, well that's unfortunate. All right, so I think what I want to do is just sack this Mind Stone. I could play Grave Titan, but I don't really like any of my options right now, so I'm just going to basically draw two cards. And just make another creature. Hit him for one in the air. And then play a Worn Power Stone on the land. Man, Mother of Runes. That was disgusting. So we'll see what he's got going on. He can attack Sorin, then attack Sorin again. Yeah, okay. So that's what he's going to do. But unless he's got something else, that Metamorph is just... Ooh, Cloud Goat Ranger. That's pretty bad. That was a good draw. That was a good draw indeed. Oh, man. Now he might re-equip. That is certainly going to be interesting for us. Faith's Fetters. Alright, so now what I'm going to do is just draw a card first. So we can play Angel of Despair, blow up the sword, but he'll be able to... It's just really, this is really awkward because we can't put fetters on a creature. We have to blow up the sword because it'll just re-equip the sword to give it pro. So we're in a bit of a pickle, so to speak. And we can play Angel Despair and blow up the sword. And I think that's actually going to be our best line. And then at that point, it's going to be, I guess, a bit of a race. Just gonna go ahead and attack with everything. And then put another lifelinker into play. He's probably gonna block there, take three, so we end up getting one. Alright, so we're attacking. Yeah, let's see if he lines these guys up. Yep, so we gain one, takes three. And then we're going to go ahead and make another guy. And play Angel of Despair. Let's see. Haven't played a land yet, I think. Nope, so let's go ahead and do that. And get the sword out of here. So now he can play his Metamorph, and he's got a lot of options here. It's just really unfortunate for us that he drew the Cloud Goat Ranger, so we couldn't really prevent him from playing having a good target. Alright, so his Metamorph is going to be, I want to say an angel, yeah. And I'm not really sure. He's probably just going to blow up our angel. He might jump and give protection, but then we'll have Faith's Fetters for Mother of Runes, and so we can sort of go on from there. And we're just going to jump his guy if he lets us do it. Alright, so he's probably gonna five us here. And pro black, yeah, kill Sorin. Okay, so let's go ahead and draw a card. Gideon, jeez. That was something. I think I'm going to save that for sometime else. And then let's put fetters on this mother of runes. And I can Inquisition him also, or I can just play. Let's see, 2, 4, 2, 4. So that'd be 7, 6, 5, down to 6. Kind of just want to play one spell then. So maybe no more lands, so we can just Inquisition to see if he's got anything. Nothing. Okay, so let's go ahead and put Faith's Fetters on that bad boy there. So now we're just going to pair off, like trade off our creatures. Then we can play Gideon, kill his angel, and should be in pretty good shape at that point. We'll have Bitter Blossom plus Active Library plus Grave Titan on the next turn. All right, so let's see what we got. Yep, attacking with all that nonsense. So we can go ahead and trade some guys. So I think it's worth just moting that guy. Then trading our lifelink guys. Those guys don't fly. All right. Might be out of the woods. Let's go ahead and draw a card. Is library good? Just curious. Tide Hollow Scholar? Be okay. So let's go ahead and play Tide Hollow Scholar. See if he drew anything. Hello? Is anyone there? Okay. All right, so we'll destroy that guy. Boom. Then attack with these guys. Then we can have 6. Can't really play any more lands, so I want to keep. I don't want to go below 6 cards, so I gotta keep this guy going. This guy put up quite a fight. Look at all these equipment cards. Certainly something. We went through some stuff. All right, drawing again. Boom. I think we've probably turned the corner in this game. Angel Serenity. Yeah, so we've got Angel of Despair and 2 guys. We can always just attack. It's plus 2 Gideon first. I want to save this Angel for a rainy day. And we'll attack and play Grave Titan. Two, and this should be enough. Play land also right now. Yeah, so we're just going to eat all of his tokens, and then there we have it. On to the next game. So this guy's got some equipments. Unfortunately, let's see, we don't really have too many ways to blow up equipment besides Vindicate, Angel of Despair. He's got Thoughtseize Inquisition. Those are both pretty good. Tide Hollow Scholar. Play Black Knight. That doesn't really solve a lot of those equipment, though. So I think I want to just run it like this. Let's see. Elspeth is also pretty good. So I think I like the way this setup. I don't really care too much for any of his other cards. There's, we can play the Abyss, but he's got some. If he has a pro artifact or a pro black sword, then on a creature, then that ends up not working out too well for us. I'm just gonna go ahead and run this.